Okay, water pump is installed, and then you'd want to check and make sure that your pulley and your impeller is working smoothly, that there's nothing behind it. And also I'm going to try to zoom in and let you see something right here. I don't know if this is going to pick it up or not. But what you're looking at right here, you can see, just barely see, you can see some of that red ATV just oozing out slightly. Now when you see that, and the camera doesn't pick it up, but I can see red all the way around that. And if you recall, I put the RTV on the outside of the O-ring. And I did that for a couple of reasons. I want to get a good seal. And the second reason is I want it on the outside because I don't want any of the silicone to get inside the water jacket. So as the water pump was compressed, it pushed the silicone to the outside. So the seal is actually on the outside of that O-ring to give it a double O-ring. I've got confidence in the O-ring, but if something were to happen to the O-ring, I've got the backup with the red RTV. Next, it's time to put the belt on. Well, first I've got to put the idler pulley back on here. And now remember, as we said when we began, all cars are going to have the belt routing diagram on it, so you can double check, and you'll do that, and then you'll just route your belt like it says. Now, here's a couple of tips. I've seen some people, they try to use this idler pulley for the last one where they try to put it around here last. What I suggest you do is go ahead and route your pulley, your belt, all the way through here and leave it off something that's on the top. For example, I left it off the alternator. It's a very easy job because you're going to be having wrenches and so forth down in this area here where your idler belt is. Just go ahead and put your breaker bar on it, pull back, have all your belts routed with the exception of your alternator belt or your air conditioner, whatever's on top. Then it's just a simple matter of slipping that belt over it, and it takes about 3 seconds to put that belt back on there. Next step is to fill the reservoir up with 50-50 antifreeze, and I'm going to use 50-50 ratio as this right here. I'm going to put in 1 gallon of antifreeze, and I'm just going to fill the remainder up with water, and that's going to be pretty close to 50-50 on this cooling system ratio. You can go between 50 and 70, 50% ratio to 70 or 70-30 ratio. That's 70% coolant to 30% water, or 50% coolant, 50% water. So take the top off of this, and I'll put the gallon of antifreeze in it. The next time you see, the old Jeep will be running. Well, I just got through with the test run on it, and the water that you see was, I just took the hose so I could rinse off any of the remaining coolant. As you know, that stuff has a smell to it, so I got it all off of there and ran the engine for about 10 or 15 minutes, and I'm just idling here in the driveway, and I've got the reservoir, I've got it tapped and pressurized, so I'll let it cool off for about an hour. I did open it up and let it run long enough for the return. This is the return hose, and make sure I was getting water flowing back into the reservoir so that I'd make sure that I had any air out of the system before I tapped it up tight, which you would want to do. But that's it. Actually, a very straightforward job here on this Jeep. Well, guys, that's it. Replacing a water pump on a Jeep Liberty. I hope perhaps you may have picked up a hint, a tip, or at least have a pretty high comfort level of changing the water pump in the Jeep. Overall, start to finish, if I had not stopped to do the videos, and of course, every time you do that, you have to go and wash up a little bit. The job, if I had had the water pump on hand, I would have probably been about an hour, and it would have been a fairly easy hour start to finish. No major obstacles. I've changed water pumps below before, and on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the most difficult, I would rank this one somewhere around a 2 or 3. It's very straightforward. You don't have to undress a lot of stuff to get to it. You don't have to take any fans off your car. Of course, this had an electric fan on it. If yours has a fan clutch or something different than what I had, it may take you a little bit longer. But I encourage you, if you have a 3.8 Chrysler product that's found in the Jeeps, as I had, or in the Chryslers or Dodges, that you go ahead and give it a whirl.
fairly straightforward job, well within the abilities of most people who work in twist wrenches around the home shop. If you're just a little bit handy, you should be able to do this. Again, for those of you that are subscribers, this is a little bit out of the ordinary. It doesn't fit the four things that I normally do, the reloading, the machine shop, ham radio, and woodworking. And if, for those of you that are Jeeps, that's not the primary use of this channel, but you're certainly welcome to subscribe. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed something. This is John, as you've seen me working in the garage shop here in Mississippi. I'll say so long to everyone.